Hello all, welcome back to CSK Technologies. In this video, we'll be seeing how to make an assembly of a crane hook. As you can see on the screen, we've been given a section view with all the balloons for all the components. And we also have a bill of material table. I have discussed what is an assembly view, exploded view, and their description details, etc. in the previous video. I'll keep the link in the description. You can click on it and go ahead and look at that video as well. Now in this video, unlike the previous video had an exploded view, but in this video we have been given a section view of 12 parts. As you can see, there are serial numbers, the name of the parts, and the quantity of how many are available. This is also a composite drawing because it's a combination of your assembly as well as all your part drawings. So we'll be looking into making of individual parts and how to do the assembly. For this, I'll make individual videos for different components and combination of a few, because these components are very small. They can be made very quickly. I'll make a video of these separately and put it in a single playlist. And finally, I'll make a video on the assembly of how to do this by understanding the section view given to us. Now, in this video, let's begin making the crane hook. As you can see on the screen, let's begin making the crane hook. We'll be using CATIA as the CAD tool for the assembly as well. To make the crane hook, we'll be using part design. So I'll be using part design, and I'll try to begin making it with the bottom and then keep adding the top shapes. So the bottom is actually not a diametrical portion. It's just a simple shape. You can make it directly and add it to 22. The remaining part is actually of a diametrical. Even this is a diametrical part. So to do so, under your pad, you can start making your sketch. As you can see, I'm trying to make this. This is supposed to be 12. And there is a continuation, so I'll try to make this only using my different curves. From here, I have around 5. And then I have another one which goes down to 25. There's also a line. I'll take the line only to the center so I can mirror it later, and then I can maintain tangency here too. Now, the same thing is actually used on the other side, so I'll just try to make this and then mirror it onto the other side as well. Mirror with respect to the center. Now we know where all the dimensions which you have given to us. This is from here to here is actually supposed to be 22, as you can see. So I'll change this to 22. Now we know that again 43, etc. is there. You can see the 43 as well. So from here to here is supposed to be 43. So let's take that as 43. And then the overall length from end to end is supposed to be 100. So this is supposed to be 100. This is the actual sketch. You can exit. Now I'd like to add it symmetrically because I want to use a shaft command for the above complete sketch. So I'll just use a mirrored event and then say 11 because I want it to 22. You can see the sketch. Now let me give round here only. There's a round actually for this, just around 11 mm. I can just take it and then give it to 11 mm. Creates a simple round. Now I can use a shaft command to create the revolve with respect to the center axis. As you know, this is my axis. You can either start it from the bottom or you can directly go to the top. So I'd use this as my reference first and then begin making my sketch. My sketch actually starts from here and then goes till down, which is supposed to be 16. So let me dimension it before I proceed further with the rest of the sketch. This is supposed to be 16 with a length of 16 only. Now, there's a small depth, as you can see, which goes this way. Again, this is 2 mm, which is given in the right view. This is 2 mm. And the diameter for this is supposed to be 15, again given in the right view. Let me take that as 15. There is again the straight line of 32, which is of 20 dia. Let me take that. Supposed to be a vertical line. And this is 32. Now there is a small addition of 5 and dia 30. So let's try to make that as well. It's a small addition this way. This is 5 to 30. 5. And the diameter is 30. Now the remaining line actually interferes with this. So let's draw this and keep it here and trim off whatever is not needed for me as usual. Now, the overall height is actually given to us as 130 from the bottom face. So I'd like to take it from the bottom face till the end and give it as 130. The sketch auto adjusts itself as per our requirement, and now we can close it and then create the revolve, which is the addition of material. Exit, it creates a revolve. Now we have a hole at this location, which is at 7 down with dia 3 through. It's on the cylindrical body, so I can directly select the cylindrical face and start making my sketch. It does it on the face only, it does not do it anywhere else. So the distance is actually supposed to be 7, so let's take this as 7. And it's supposed to be located exactly at the center. So I'd like to coincide with the axis difference, whichever I'm getting whenever I'm trying to move the mouse. Now the diameter is 6. We know it's through. So I'll just try to give it through and then say, okay. This is your crane hook. You can save the file and then continue with the next component as well. So we'll end the video of crane hook here. If you like our channel, please subscribe. It helps us, motivates us to post more videos like this, which can be helpful for your practice sessions. Thank you.